Can something as simple as onion water help your orchids to thrive? Today, I'll take you through two recipes on onion water and explain to you how they work and whether they actually are safe to use on your orchid. One of the recipes going to be simple, the other one's going to be stronger, but which one will be safer? Before we start rushing off to the kitchen and cooking up our wonder cure, let's have a look at some of the reasons why onion water could be considered worthwhile using for your orchids. Especially red onions have a lot of those organic compounds in them that could supply benefit to your orchids with antioxidants, antibacterial or antifungal actions, and other enzymes and things that can help your orchid. Well, there'll be a lot of ifs and buts and whens and hows that we'll give you later. First, let's look at all of those wonderful components. There's all those amazing antioxidants from your flavonoids, your anthocyanins, which are basically your color pigments, and there's the antimicrobial activity from your phenolic acids and other enzymes and compounds like allicin. Remember, allicin is something that we showed you with the garlic water. Although onions do have a different form of it, and it's really not quite as potent as what garlic does. So it's not going to give you the same benefit in that way. And there are also all those sulfur compounds in your onions that really supply it with that antifungal punch that we are looking for. So let's show you these two different recipes and see which ones benefit from which of these compounds. So first we'll just go with the easy recipe. What we're going to do is we're just basically going to be using the onion peels and the onion skin. And what we're looking for is around 20 grams or so of that onion peel that you're not actually going to be using in your meal anyway, so it's you're not actually really wasting any onion doing it. So we can just take all that peel that you might not have been using anyway, and what we're going to do is throw it into this water that's about to boil. Of course, you can cut it up smaller just to help with any of that removal of the substances from the smaller pieces than it is from larger pieces, giving a bigger surface area that the compounds can escape from. And as I said, this is the easy recipe. That's basically all that you have to do to that is we just put those into boiling water, let it boil for a short time. We don't want to let it boil for too long because the heat of the water will slowly degrade some of those components that we're trying to draw out of it. There we go. We'll just take it off the heat now and then just allow that, set that aside and allow that to cool. So what this has done now, it's drawn out all of those antioxidants, those anthocyanins and flavonoids from the peels and the cell walls that might not have come out otherwise if you're using just cold water. But understand, when using hot water, you are now causing degrading of all of those sulfur compounds. So this is not going to have the same sort of antifungal or antimicrobial activity as what a preparation done with cold water is going to have. So you'll end up with higher antioxidants, but lower antimicrobials. As I said, we'll let this sit and cool, and then we'll strain out the onion water. And now for the stronger recipe. This takes a lot more work. What we're going to need to do is we're going to have to chop our onion up. So this might make us cry a little. A blender can also work to do this, but then often in a blender you may waste a lot of your onion. It's not always easy to get out of your blender properly. And then we'll just put this into our mortar. And beat it up good and proper. So what you're trying to do here is break down those cells inside the onion itself so that you can then squeeze out all the liquid that's inside of them. So if you have a muslin cloth or something, you can turn this out into your muslin cloth and then squeeze it and get all that onion juice, and then that's what you're looking for to use. And what we want is we want to squeeze out enough juice to fill about a tablespoon. So we want about 20 grams of this onion juice that we're then going to put into the water. Okay, and then we'll put that straight into 1 liter of room temperature water and stir that in. And then that there is immediately ready for use. We can immediately see the difference between the two formulations. This is the one to which heat was added that's drawn out all those color pigments from the onion skin. And these are the anthocyanins that are antioxidants. This one here, we just used room temperature water. We squeezed out all those juices from the inside of the onion itself, and we mixed it into the water. We can see there's a slight pink tinge to it, so we understand there's not quite as many antioxidants, but this will still have all of those sulfur compounds that are going to be antifungal. So this one's going to have a much weaker effect on your plant than what this one is going to have. This specific formulation we got from a scientific study, and they used this formulation at that 20 grams per liter to increase the root growth on their orchids, and they found that no other concentration was there any discernible increase in the growth of the roots. But at that 20 grams per liter, they found that they had an amazing increase in your root growth. So this is an excellent tonic to increase the root growth of your orchids, although there have been no studies done on it being used in a domestic situation in media that's not aseptic. Although with the large number of anecdotal reports from orchid growers all around the world, it seems to work for a lot of people. Although some people say they have found it has no effect whatsoever. But then also you have to remember with this specific formulation, this is going to go off really quickly. You have to use it within the first 24, possibly 48 hours of making it. As soon as you see a browning of the liquid or you smell a slight souring, you cannot use this any longer. Also remember, this is probably only a single use application. You're going to dunk your roots of your plant that's not looking so good. You're gonna let the roots soak in it for around 15 or 20 minutes, then remove it and not apply this again. This is not a tonic that you're then going to be watering in on and around your orchids because of the volatile compounds in it that then can decompose. This, as the compounds decompose, they can then start forming extra microbial or fungal growth in them. So it's not going to be a good idea to be adding this to your media, especially if you're using it more than once. Whereas this, on the other hand, is probably a good long-term solution to adding to your orchid. It's at a much lower strength. It's not going to give you the same antifungal properties, but it's going to give you all those antioxidants that your orchids enjoy. But still, this again, you need to use within the first 2 or 3 days. Unless refrigerated, you might get it to last slightly longer, but both of these need to be used fresh. And with the stronger formulation that's been done with room temperature water, there are also other compounds and enzymes in it that are going to help your orchid. But remember, overuse of this is phytotoxic, meaning that it can kill your plant. It's going to disrupt the metabolism, cause malformations in the growth, and eventually kill your plant. Also, it's going to help sour your media faster. So that's why I always suggest, if you're going to be using this onion water, remove your plant from the pot that it is in, dunk its roots, and then repot it in fresh media afterwards. And this specific formulation you can use not only as a foliar spray, but also as a drench. But I would never use it more than once a month. And that's only during the growing season. So there has been a lot of fanfare about red onion water helping your orchids get better blooms, grow amazing sets of roots, and just become the most beautiful, big, lush plant that you can ever imagine. But remember, if you are going to be using it, only use it as a part of your orchid care regime. This isn't the wonder cure that people like to make you think it out as it's going to be. Remember, it can be phytotoxic, so it can cause real problems for your plant if you're using it incorrectly. There are other ways of getting the same results as what you can from onion water on your orchids using other products. But if you're in a tight squeeze and you really need to get it done quickly and all you've got is onions in your kitchen, then go ahead, use it, but use it carefully. And if you're unsure what those products are, check that Buy Me a Coffee link in the description box down there below. There's a lot of information that Ed posts up there all the time with regards to orchids and how to grow them well. And we also have a broad range of other videos available. Check out that Orchid Care playlist on our homepage. And if you found any of this information helpful in any way, please hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and that notification bell, bing bong, to be notified of all our upcoming content so you don't miss out on a thing. Help us grow as we help your orchids grow.